Everything we say should be to the glory of God. If it's not our goal, if it's not our priority, it will not happen. We have to wake up with this mentality, and we have to go to bed with this mentality.
Yes, sir.
That, and this is not something that naturally comes.
Right.
It doesn't come from, we're not born with this desire to give him the glory. We're not born with that desire.
Right.
The desire that we're born with is our own desire,
yes,
to give ourselves the glory.
Right.
But when God does a work in our hearts,
yeah,
he puts this desire in us,
yes,
that we want to give him the glory.
Mm.
We want to be all pleasing unto him.
Yes,
that's
right.
But
yes,
if it's not my goal to do it in everything that I do,
yes,
I won't do it.
Mm-hmm.
He will not be glorified if it's not my intention.
Right.
So we serve God on purpose.
Amen.
We serve him intentionally.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
If you offend someone with the word of God,
mm-hmm,
then that was your intention.
Amen.
That's okay.
Amen.
If they get offended by the word of God, that's okay, because the word of God can offend.
Yes, sir.
The Lord didn't convict me because everything was in agreement with my will. The conviction came because everything came against me.
Yes,
show me his will and show me what I was doing against his. That's conviction.
Amen.
Amen. If it's always easy and nice, then we're not going to grow. Conviction comes when something, when the word goes against what I am doing in offense to him.
Amen.
When that's brought to my attention,
amen,
that's what convicts us.
Amen.
It should be our goal to glorify him.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Every born again believer, we are to grow in the knowledge of the Lord.
Amen.
We are to grow, we are to increase in knowledge.
Yes.
Thank God for the testimony Deacon Pickens up here teaching. And I don't know if you know it or not, but it blesses my heart to hear men and women that are broken.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I'm talking about that say that I'm nothing and he's everything.
Yeah.
That I can do nothing without him.
That's right. That's right.
There's nothing good about me. It's all about his righteousness.
Amen.
That blesses me, praise God.
Amen.
Amen. And be careful of those that talk about how powerful they are.
That's right, brother.
The apostles were powerful,
yes, sir,
but they never bragged about it.
That's what I mean, brother.
Amen.
When the Spirit of the Lord was upon them, was operating in them, they demonstrated that it was.
Yes, sir.
That's good. That's good.
There was a practice and a conduct.
Right.
And there was some results,
yeah,
of the Holy Spirit being present.
Amen. That's right.
Amen. But these men, King David, they were powerful, but they were broken.
Yeah.
Amen. So we get weary about people that talk about how powerful they are. But if we're going to be anything or do anything, we're going to do it in total submission to him. Humble at his feet. Lord, use me to your glory. I thank God for the prayers. As I said, you know, that's a good prayer, you know. So somebody doing too much good stuff, though.
Right.
She's not saying she's just out there sinning or anything of that nature. They say they're doing so much. Their hearts are bigger than their ability.
Amen.
Hear those prayers. That's a good prayer. You know, slow me down.
Amen.
You know, and the Lord, there are things that you desire to do. Just pray that it will be done, and God will send laborers. Not to send other people to do what we desire to do. That's a good prayer that you have. And I hear men, I hear the women, I hear all of our prayers. I want you to know that when you say, pray for me, that this happened. I'm praying God's will happen. Now, I don't know if you see it how I see it, but when you say, as Mr. Hall was saying, I pray that, you know, he would be the leader in his house and do things like that. He understand it. I pray that it be just like the scriptures say.
Amen. That's right, brother.
The servant God has called me to be and those different things, I pray that it be exactly as God said it would.
Yeah.
Amen.
Even if it brings opposition, I still pray it happen.
Yeah.
Jesus went into the garden to pray. And as Deacon Pickett pointed out, he said, not my will, thy will be done. And if God's will be done, look what Jesus had to go through. He suffered on the cross in order that God's will be done. So sometimes when we pray, it's not a quick fix. It's not we're going to go home and everything is going to be in order. Sometimes when we pray, that's going to be some opposition. But it causes us to depend and trust upon God's divine assistance. So there is going to be some suffering in what we're praying for. Got to be willing. So praying is not avoiding what it's going to take in order that God's will come forth. It may be, give me the strength, as Mother Wallace was saying, give me the strength to endure whatever that is. Amen. So whatever it takes for us to get our houses and our marriages and our finances, those things that we deal with daily, whatever it takes to get that right, Lord, I pray it happens. We pray it happens just as he said it will.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
It's not God, you go fix it and then I'll show up. Praise God, man. The book of Colossians, we're going to read from the first verse. It says, Paul, an apostle of Jesus Christ, by the will of God, and Timothy is our brother to the saints and faithful brethren in Christ, which are at Colossae. Grace be unto you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. We give thanks to God for God the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, praying always for you since we heard of your faith in Christ Jesus and of the love which you have to all saints. They have faith in Christ, and the faith that they have is demonstrated in the love that they have to all saints. If I have faith in Christ, that means I love you.
That's right. That's right.
I love the saints. Amen. We have love one for another if we have faith in Christ. For the hope which is laid up for you in heaven, whereof you heard before in the word of the truth of the gospel, which is come unto you as it is in all the world and bringeth forth fruit. Look what the gospel does. The truth of the gospel is come unto you as it is in all the world, and guess what the gospel does? It bringeth forth what? Bringeth forth fruit as it does also in you, since the day ye heard of it and knew the grace of God in truth. How did they know the grace of God in truth? They heard about the gospel.
Yes.
As ye also have learned of Epaphras, our dear fellow servant, who is for you a faithful minister of Christ, who also declared unto us your love in the Spirit. For this cause we also, since the day we heard it, do not cease to pray for you, and to desire. Listen, this is it. This is all of our desire. And I pray that this is your desire for me. Mm-hmm. Pray for you and to desire that you may be filled with the knowledge of his will. Mm-hmm. In all wisdom and spiritual understanding. That should be our desire for everyone. Mm-hmm. Amen. All of the saints. That should be our desire. And if you are filled with the knowledge of his will in all wisdom and spiritual understanding, look at your walk.
Right.
How are you walking worthy? It's because you understand it.
Right.
It's because you're growing in him.
Right, brother.
That you may walk worthy, not of yourself, not of your family, but you walk worthy of the Lord unto all pleasing, being fruitful in what? Every good work, and increasing in the knowledge of God.
Yes.
The greatest goal in life, the highest goal in life, is to be pleasing unto God.
Yes.
That's the greatest goal you can ever have. If you never graduate from school, if you never get the job you desire, if you never leave your state, your country, and travel the world, your greatest desire will be is to be all pleasing unto the Lord.
That's right. Amen.
You can die right there.
That's right. Yeah.
That's good. There's no other. That was Jesus' number one goal. Was to do the will of his Father.
Amen.
Ain't that good news?
Yeah.
Praise God. That should be our desire. Strengthened with all might. According to what? His glorious power. Paul said, I can do all things through what?
Right.
With what? Not your strength, it's not my strength. We can't do it within ourselves, but we can do all things through Christ, which gives us the strength. And let me show you that this strength, according to his glorious power, will do for you. I heard Deacon Pickett talking about it this morning, unto all patience. Do we need patience sometimes?
Yes.
Ooh, yes, we need patience. Amen. Patience is not just waiting, it's how you wait. Amen. Patience is having the strength to not do what others have done to you.
That's right, brother.
Patience is to have the strength to say that vengeance belongs to the Lord.
That's right. Amen.
Vengeance says, Lord, tame my tongue. Teach me not just to hold my peace, but let me cast down the imagination that came and wanted me to say something.
Yes,
because somebody said, well, I had to hold my peace because I wanted to say this. If you wanted to say that, you see it. Patience is giving it all to God and saying, God, I'm dependent totally up on you that I may be fruitful. That when I am squoze the wrong way, and when I'm hit from the left side or the right side, that I may respond in the fruit of the Spirit. That's strength. When somebody hates you, you can love them. Amen. We need patience. Because most of the things we encounter all day, most of the time, it's not agreeable to us. Most of the time, it's not.
Yeah.
And how do we make it through and still give God the glory? We got to have patience. We got to have patience. Amen. And that is not something that we're born with.
Amen.
Amen. We're born impatient, right?
That's right.
We're born. Mother Wallace talked about her temper. We all have one. Some people are shorter than us. We all have a temper. However, people say, you got to have self-control. No, you need to have Holy Ghost control. You need to have control of you.
Right.
Mother, yes, the Holy Spirit should be your temper.
Right.
That when people, when something happens to me, that I respond with patience, long suffering, gentleness, meekness, trust in God. Amen.
Amen.
What it is, we depend upon we through this, and that's why we fail. Amen. But he strengthens us no matter what comes. He strengthens with all might. No matter what comes. Give me a situation that God can't get you through. Strengthen with all might. What you need? How much you need? How long you need it? All might. He'll give you the strength for it. But we have to desire that. When you wake up in the morning, Lord, give me the strength to walk before you all pleasing. Amen. The phone ring, Lord, I don't know who it is, I don't know what it's about, but God, my desire is to be pleasing to you on this phone. When you leave out the house, you go to the grocery, you go to work, you go to school, you go to the store, Lord, Holy Spirit, lead me.
Yeah.
Let the next word that I say to whoever it is, let it be all pleasing. Yes, everything. Amen. Somebody come to you in the wrong attitude. Before I respond, Lord, give me the strength to exercise patience. Give me the strength to respond opposite of them.
Yes, sir.
That will cause them to turn away and make them look at themselves and say, you know what, I came at you wrong. Amen. Give me that strength. All right, according to his glorious power, to all patience and long suffering, praise the Lord with joyfulness. Praise the Lord. Giving thanks unto the Father, which have made us meet to be partakers of the inheritance of the saints in life. Now listen, God gives us strength for everything we face.
That's right.
Everything. Amen. You know, like I say in the world, there's a lawyer for everything. People can sue for anything. And win. But God has the grace for everything. There's nothing God's grace can't do.
Right.
Amen.
Amen.
Gives us the grace. He gives us the strength. He gives us the ability that otherwise we would not have.
Amen.
To do whatever his will is.
Amen.
Ain't that good news?
Amen.
Then he didn't stop that.
Yeah.
He has made us meet or fit to be partakers.
Yes, sir.
Of a great inheritance.
Yes, sir.
Ain't that good news?
Amen.
We have an inheritance.
Yeah.
Praise the Lord that is in the heavens.
Uh-huh.
An inheritance ain't like the inheritance on this earth.
Uh-huh.
See, I find a lot of times most of our frustrations come because we are chasing things that are temporal.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Right.
We so tired,
yeah,
frustrated, ready to give up. We're mad.
Yeah.
And why are we mad? It's because we're chasing something temporary.
Yes, sir.
And God has already given us the ability to be content.
Yeah.
With such things we have.
Yeah.
Why? Because there's nothing down here that money can buy. There's nothing down here, I don't care how beautiful it is.
Yeah.
I don't care how many people came together,
right,
and made it something in their eyes. There's nothing that can compare,
amen,
to the glory we have,
right,
in Christ Jesus. Anything.
Amen.
Nothing that can compare,
yeah,
to the inheritance.
Yes.
Now, how do you know that this inheritance is valuable? Because God gave it to us.
Amen.
How do you know that this inheritance is valuable? Because it's in heaven.
Yes. Yes, sir.
How do you know it's better than the inheritance of anything on this earth? Because it's undefiled.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
What's the difference? Everything down here corrupts.
Yes.
And we so foolish, you know what we do? We go and try to restore stuff that's corrupted.
Yeah.
We try to go and put paint on something and say, don't that look brand new? It's still corrupting. It's fading away.
Yeah.
But we have an inheritance.
Yes, sir.
It does not fade away.
It does not fade.
When the Lord saved us in Christ Jesus,
yes,
we receive a great inheritance.
Yes, sir. That's right.
And that inheritance can't be touched,
right,
can't be taken away from us,
right,
and it only gets better to us,
yes,
as we live on this earth.
Right.
We appreciate it more and more.
Yes.
Amen. 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 Our salvation is secure.
Uh-huh.
In Christ Jesus.
Yeah.
It gets sweeter,
amen,
as the day go by, they say.
Yeah.
Ain't it a great inheritance?
Yeah.
Ain't it a beautiful salvation?
Yeah.
And all things beautiful in Him?
Yeah.
You know, I've been falling asleep, and it's been a good rest. But my wife said I'm snoring. I think I have a sinus infection. She said I was just snoring like a machine.
Yeah.
I mean, she said it's ridiculous. But the rest is good.
Yeah, yeah.
I wake up disoriented. Don't know what's going on. Never feeling good while you wake me up. But let me tell you something about this inheritance we have. We can rest in it. Praise God. I'm talking about we can rest. Mother, we can rest from our labors. We don't have to try to do anything to stay in righteousness before God. To stay justified before God. We don't have to try to do anything.
Yes,
amen. God gives us the strength. He saves us unto good works.
Yeah.
Amen. We can rest.
Yes, sir.
And also rest from worry.
Yeah.
We don't have to worry anymore.
Yeah.
We can rest.
Yeah.
Because God is our Father.
Yes,
yeah.
He takes care of the birds of the air and He clothes the grass.
Yeah.
We don't have to worry.
Yeah.
We can rest in Him. Don't have to worry, praise God. We can rest confident,
yeah,
knowing that whatever we have need of, God's going to take care of.
Yes,
ain't that good news?
Yeah.
We can rest in Him.
Right.
That's
right.
No more worry.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
What a good rest.
Praise
anybody resting?
Yes, sir.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
And while we rest, and guess what? It gets better.
Yes, sir.
One day we're going to leave Him and we're going to rest some more for eternity. Enter into that great rest.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
We're
not worried about sin no more.
No.
These things that come to hinder us.
Yeah.
These things that come to slow us down.
Yes,
these things that come to tempt us.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. We're going to be able to be with Christ.
Yeah.
We're going to be in glory. We're going to see Him face to face. We're going to see Him as He is. No interruptions. Nothing in the way. We'll be all pleasing.
Yes,
sir. Unto Him.
Yeah.
Walking in joy.
Yeah.
And gladness, praise
yeah.
God.
Yeah.
And we're partakers. He made us partakers with other saints.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
Ain't that good news?
Yeah. Yeah.
It also tells us that we were not fit.
Mm-hmm.
We were unfit to be partakers
yes.
of that inheritance.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we were unfit of the saints in light. So the
yeah.
saints are in light.
Mm-hmm.
So God had to make us fit
mm-hmm.
to be partakers
right.
of the saints
yes.
who are in the light.
Yeah.
He had to make us fit. So what were we?
Darkness.
Darkness.
The saints are in light.
Right.
Amen.
Mm-hmm.
And you remember, better than I remember. You remember you was in darkness.
Right. That's right, brother.
And you remember how you hated the people that were in the light.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Oh, such a great resistance.
Yeah.
You know, church used to be punishment to me. If you still feel like church is punishment, then you don't know the Lord.
Right.
I love church.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
Tell me, hey, look, you got a choice. You can retire, you can stop working today and go to church for the rest of your life as if that was a punishment. I'm going to church. I love the saints.
Yeah.
I love the things of God.
Yeah.
I love the fellowship.
Yeah.
I love to hear those testimonies. Amen. I love to hear the words of God. I I love to hear how God has blessed people. I love to hear that. Don't get mad at me or mad at somebody because they're getting blessed. Praise God with them.
Amen.
Now I tell you, when I do cringe, I'm gonna be honest. God is a great, He's our greatest provider. He takes care of us. But when I see people shout more because God gave them something material, then they are grateful about the salvation. That's I get concerned.
Yeah.
I mean, I've seen people, I'm talking about, they crying and shouting, going around the church and everything, and it be a car, and then 3 months later, they won't pay for it. Even jobs, I've seen them, God bless me with a job, and they're just going forward, and then they mad at the boss on the job, yeah. Mad because they gotta work more.
Right, so.
But they said God gave it to them.
Right.
But guys, listen, let me tell you something, never get old.
Right.
It's this great salvation.
Yeah.
Satisfied in Jesus.
Yeah.
He's all we need.
Yeah.
He's all in all. It gets better, and it gets better, and it gets better. The more we know about Him, the more we glorify Him. Amen. The more we know about Him, the more we want to serve Him.
Yeah.
We're just so grateful of what He has done. They don't get up.
Yeah.
Testify the great salvation that, look, I there was a job I wanted, but I didn't get it, but I thank God for saving me.
Yeah.
Ain't that good?
Yeah.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Okay, so. Partakers, here's our scripture. Who? So it says, giving thanks unto the Father. That's verse 12. The Father, which have made us meet to be partakers of light, of partakers of the inheritance of the saints in light. Who? That who is God the Father.
Yeah.
Ain't that good news?
Yeah.
Look what it said God did. Who have. If you don't know tonight, you're already delivered.
That's right.
Right.
You're delivered.
Yeah.
Anything that was under the power of darkness.
Mm-hmm.
Look, He didn't just deliver us from darkness.
Right.
Read the scripture.
Mm-hmm.
He didn't just deliver you from darkness.
Power.
He delivered us from what?
The power. Yeah.
The power of darkness.
Yeah.
That means something had us bound.
Yeah.
We were born in darkness.
Yeah.
We were born under the power of darkness.
Yeah.
Under the power of Satan.
Yeah.
Under the power of Satan's influence.
Yeah.
Of the power and the course of this world.
Yeah.
But under the power of your flesh.
Yeah.
Under the power of all things evil, we were born into it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But Paul said, God, the Father, has made us meet or fit to be partakers of inheritance with the people, with the saints
light.
Who are in light.
Yeah.
How did He do it? He said, who have?
Yes, right. Yes, sir.
Wait a minute. If I was bound by Satan, the world, the flesh, if I was bound by this, if I were born into this and it had me bound, the only way I could get out is I need something more powerful than what had me bound.
Right.
So Paul, he said, he didn't say what delivered me. He said, who delivered me?
Right.
Amen.
Right.
So I needed something more powerful than my own will.
Yes,
I needed something more powerful than my own desires.
Yes.
I needed something more powerful than the ways of this world.
Yes.
I needed something more powerful than the prince of the power of the air.
Yes.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Right.
People bound to sin,
yeah.
You need something more powerful than sin that can destroy sin.
Yes.
Sin leads to death. You need something that is more powerful than death.
Yeah.
Right,
the heart is wicked and evil. You need something more powerful than evil and wickedness.
Yeah.
Right.
That can give you a new heart.
Yeah.
more powerful than deception, and that's the truth.
Amen.
Jesus said, I'm the way,
the truth,
and the life. No man can come to the Father except by me. He has delivered us. Has he delivered us?
Yes.
Yes, he has delivered us. And let me tell you, you didn't accidentally walk into the kingdom of God. You didn't just trip up and end up in there.
Yeah.
And you didn't come up with some old funny words and repeat the preacher and get thrown in there.
Yeah.
No, sir. I want you to know, Jesus told Nicodemus, Nicodemus, you must be born again. There's no other way in to the kingdom of God except you are born from above.
Yeah.
Amen. Amen. Yeah. If you want to see, or if you are to enter this kingdom, you must be born again. Born of the water and of the Spirit. You must be. It's not an option. You must be. On the way in, it's, you must be born again.
Yeah.
Ain't that good news?
Yeah. Yeah.
He have delivered us.
Yeah.
We've been born again.
Yes, sir.
Praise the Lord.
Yeah.
We've been born again. Yeah. He's changed our hearts. Yeah. Gave us a new heart. That's good news.
Yeah.
Deliver us from the power. Sin no longer has dominion over us.
Yes.
Right. Praise God. Yes. And so when he delivers us from the kingdom of God, guess what our next attitude, I mean from the power of darkness, guess what our next attitude is to seek it.
Yes.
Pursue it. Make it our priority. Seek ye first what?
Kingdom.
Of God. And here's what?
Right.
And what's going to happen?
All
everything we need. He blessed us with all spiritual blessings in heavenly places. He's given us what we need spiritually. He gives us what we need naturally. We can be content with what such things we have. God takes care of us. We don't have to worry.
Yes.
Amen.
Bless his name.
Praise the Lord. God has blessed us. And he puts this desire in us to seek the kingdom in everything.
Yes.
And his righteousness. Can't leave that out. God, I need to do this right. I need to do this as you would have me to do it. Make it your priority. Amen. He delivers. And so everything we do, we're doing it to his glory. We're doing it intentionally. We do it on purpose. If we don't make it our goal to bring him glory, then we won't do it. Amen. So he told us to seek the kingdom. And so while we're seeking the kingdom, guess what? He gives us a conduct and a behavior. He gives us the strength that, listen, because you are in the kingdom of light, because you're in the kingdom of his dear son, you're still in the midst of this old evil world. You're still incarcerated in this old evil body. There's a spiritual warfare continually going on. But we wrestle not against what? But against what? Spiritual wickedness. And let me tell you this. If you don't think about the spiritual battle that is continuously going on, then what concern do you truly have for the kingdom of God? That is a spiritual battle going on. And it must be at the forefront of our minds.
Yes.
But the world is designed to take our minds off of what's really happening. That's a, he said we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but most of our problems is against flesh and blood. But God takes care of that. He said, vengeance is mine. God will judge. God will hold folks accountable. You just, God gives us the strength to continue to give him the glory.
Right. Yes.
But we wrestle so much. Who are we mad at? We mad at somebody, ain't we? But we don't see the force behind it. And it's such a battle going on. Our children are in this battle. And we send them out unprepared every day.
Yeah.
Guys, we've got to be mindful of this spiritual battle going on. The spirit of the end is, people, I know the Antichrist is coming, but the Spirit's here now.
That's right, sir.
And we can't be having these little funny games and tricks going on, people dancing, doing mime and all that stuff up here, and
right.
Drill teams and all that stuff, thinking that we're prepping them for the Spirit of the Antichrist.
Right.
That don't prep them.
Right.
We've got to teach them the law, the Lord.
Amen.
We got to teach them the Scripture.
Amen.
We got to bring them up in the nurture and admonition of the law.
Right.
We have to. It's not optional.
Yes,
well, what's the consequence? They're going to be bound to the ways of this world.
Right.
Snuffed out so easily. But the thing it is now, we're just handing them over. It's not even a challenge for Satan anymore.
Right.
It's not a challenge for the world anymore. We're just handing our children over.
Right.
Oh. Guys, listen. I was telling somebody the other day. we can't be led by our children. We're to lead our children.
Right. Right.
Got these folks following their kids to every game,
that's
everything
right.
They want to do, concert they want to do, whatever my child wants.
Right.
And see, that's the way the kingdom of darkness talks.
That's right, mother.
The kingdom of darkness is against the kingdom of light.
That's right.
The kingdom of darkness, the kingdom of this world. Listen, the world teaches us this. The world teaches us men. It teaches us.
Yeah.
Women are to be aggressive, men be passive. That's what the world teaches.
Right.
But that goes against God's
right.
order. It teaches it teaches that abortion is okay. It teaches that homosexuality is virtuous.
Yes.
That's what the world teaches.
Right.
The world teaches, it teaches us that, listen, shacking is fine.
Yeah.
Divorce don't harm nobody. That's your choice. Just do it again. Over and over. It says it has no consequences. The world teaches us to just be passive as the church. It teaches us that we can't judge people.
Right.
Even if they are murderers.
Yeah.
And doing things totally against God. It teaches us to be silent. That's what the world does. The world says sex is okay as long as it's safe. The world teaches that you can change your gender. No, you can't. That's what the world teaches. That's under the kingdom of darkness.
Amen.
Now, the kingdom of darkness, how close is it to us? Let me tell you, the kingdom of darkness, we're in it right now. But we are children of the light.
Amen.
And though we're in the kingdom of darkness, we're to walk as children of light. Walk in the light as what? He is in the light. So dark things, yes, it's going to have a hatred for how we live. It's going to have a hatred for how we stand. But listen, you want to do, how do we identify things that are not of God in our lives? Because if it's not of God, it's of darkness.
Right. Right.
We might make a middle ground with it, but God doesn't.
Right.
So with our goal or our mission to do all things to the glory of God,
yeah.
If we do it on purpose, we're going to say, God, we want to do it according to God's truth, according to God's will.
Mm-hmm.
That way we won't let no mediocrity fit in. No middle ground. You understand what I'm saying? So, you know, if my wife and I, in my household, is it ruled by the kingdom of darkness or by the kingdom of his dear son? In Christ's kingdom, there's joy and peace.
Yes, sir.
That's right. There's quietness. Is your house ruled by quietness? Is it ruled by peace? Is it ruled by joy? Or is it ruled by arguing, fussing, bitterness, malice, envy? How is it ruled? Our conduct and our interaction with our children Is it ruled by the kingdom of God? Does it identify that Christ is on the throne of our heart? Or does it identify that there's darkness being ruled in our house? He have delivered us. He have delivered us, listen, from. So that that used to rule us don't rule us anymore. So it shouldn't be in association with us. Me and my wife were saved. So what goes on with us, even if it's because we're in a relationship, there's going to be conflict. But that's fine. But God teaches us how to deal with conflict as Christians. And we should do that according as God wants us to do it. But if there's a lot of name calling, a lot of putting down and things like that, then that's darkness. That's worldly. That's fleshy. Should be able to come together and pray. Say, Lord, give me the strength, as Mother Wilde was saying, give me the strength not to have these thoughts. Give me the strength to let there be peace. Amen. And be quietness. Amen. Mm-hmm. And that's what it should be. Even in our interaction, I had a brother tell me the other day that he became very conscious of how he had responded to his daughter. He wasn't ugly or ugly to her, but he wanted to make sure, when it was brought to his attention, he wanted to make sure it was proper. Because we should never agree with something that is not proper. So when he was confronted with it, he responded. He took it sweetly, and he went and made it right. How many of us do that? We recognize, sometimes we don't always do things right, God. Guys, and God is going to send somebody to point that out to us. Mm-hmm. And if you respond and been who you trying to tell me, talking to me, you can't tell me anything. And then you start bringing up everything that they do so that you don't have to face what you're doing.
Right.
But he took it sweetly. And he went and he made it right. Sweet. Guys, that's how we respond. We're not saying we don't face things in this world as others do, but we have a different way we respond. Amen? Amen. So he said, who have delivered us from the what? Power of, he delivered us from it and have translated us into the kingdom of his what?
Yes.
Praise God, he has. Let me tell you something. Positionally, brothers, y'all come on, I know time is running out. Positionally, we're perfect. Mm-hmm. Positionally,
right.
We have been made righteous.
Right.
Righteousness of God. Mm-hmm. We are justified in Him. Mm-hmm. Perfect.
Right.
That can't change and it won't change. There's nothing you can do to make yourself more justified. Mm-hmm. Nothing you can do to add to your justification. Mm-hmm. Christ has done that work.
Right.
There's nothing you can do. Amen.
Yeah.
Nothing. However, in practice, we're progressing.
Mm-hmm.
We're persevering. And God gives us strength that we may show that we are partakers of that great inheritance. Mm-hmm. We are able to walk in the light as He is in the light.
Amen.
Amen.
Right.
God has delivered us from the power of darkness.
Yes. Amen.
Amen. That is a great deliverance.
Right.
Because it had us bound.
Right.
Yes.
And the things we used to think, the things we used to say, the way we used to behave, we don't behave like that anymore.
Right.
And we should not desire that any of our family members and friends be bound to the ways of this world. Pray for their deliverance. And I'm not just talking about off of drugs, out of a certain relationship. No, they need to, the relationship they need to be delivered from is the relationship from the bounds and the clutches of Satan.
That's right.
Amen. Into the kingdom.
Amen.
In into a relationship with Jesus Christ.
Amen.
That's our prayer. Come on, brother. Amen.
Amen.
If you don't mind, so praise the Lord. So he hath delivered us from the power of darkness unto the kingdom of his dear son. There's so much more to say. We don't have time to follow.